planner, Survivor SA contestant, and Gay Games medalist, Zavion Kotze is joining me in studio. I'm so excited.
Thank you. So am I. It's so cool to be here. It's an awesome background.
Right?
Wow, all these working people.
These are all
they make
the
me
journalists.
They make me feel guilty. And also a little bit of like fear.
Why?
I don't know. I'm scared of journalists.
Why?
I don't know. I've gone through some bad experiences.
Do you feel scared right now?
Yes.
Are you afraid of what's
going to happen?
I am
afraid of you. And it's Halloween as well. So,
I know. Yeah. Who knows?
Cool. Ooh. Who knows? Ooh.
Okay. Cool. I'm super interested about the Gay Games. I know it happened in August, yeah. But I need to ask you about it.
Yeah.
So you won a ton of medals. How many medals did you win?
I won 8 gold medals and 3 silvers and a bronze.
Yes. And it's all athletics.
Yeah, hey. all athletics. Yeah.
Okay, so is this the first Gay Games you've been to?
Yeah, this is the first Gay Games I went to. And it came about when I did Survivor last year. Mm-hmm. I kind of like wanted to know what I'm going to do next year because I knew it was going to take a lot of like from my body and I wouldn't be able to compete on the level that I wanted to.
Yeah.
So I decided to do the Gay Games, not only because it's a fun thing to do. You know, I'm a firm believer in equality, mm-hmm. and especially equality in sport. And that's what the Gay Games promotes. It's not exclusively for only gay people. Straight people can take part, transsexual, transgender, everyone can take part. And you know what, it's just such a friendly mm-hmm. environment. And there wasn't one moment with my experience there that I felt that people aren't happy. It was constant mm-hmm. love and constant support and very competitive, actually. I thought it would be a walk in the park. And it really wasn't. It was tough. It was a tough couple of days that I went through, but it was cool. I enjoyed it.
That's awesome. Now, you are quite outspoken as an activist for LGBT yeah. rights in South Africa. Do you feel like progress is being made here?
We are so blessed. Every single time someone asks me when I was overseas, you know, what's you know LGBT rights like in mm-hmm. South Africa? And we have amazing rights. In this country, and we have had for many years. So we are very blessed when it comes to that. There are still just the stigmas and the people that don't fully accept and that like that treat us differently, even though we're all people.
Yeah.
I mean, it's so strange. Every time someone meets me, they're like, you're gay? Like, I know I'm gay, and my family is like, please. When I came out of the closet, they were like, we know you're gay. So it's, you know, when I was overseas trying to explain to people what it's like in South Africa, we're very, very lucky. The rest of the continent, however, we know that there are yeah. so many countries that are struggling with it, and it's illegal to be gay. You know, Zambia, one of our bordering countries, it's very frowned upon, and, you know, you can get arrested for being caught. So Jeez. It's really tough. So that's why I went over. I went over not only to represent South Africa, but Africa as a continent, and hopefully I can get a couple more athletes over for the next one.
That's awesome. When is the next one?
The next one is in 2018. Mm-hmm. It is at Paris.
Is it in Paris?
Yes, Paris.
That will be beautiful.
Yeah, it will
can
be
I
very
come?
Cool. Yes, come.
Okay.
I'd love to have you
okay.
there. It would be awesome. Just come and do a sport, any sport. They've got every single sporting category. It's literally like if you want to run, swim, jump, throw, basketball, football, baseball, darts.
Darts?
Bowling.
Is that a sport?
Yes, it's a sport apparently. I don't know. I was very impressed with those people's skill. Like, I've never. I thought like darts is like drinking
drinking
just
and
don't
that.
Be careful. Like don't like hit someone in the forehead with a dart. But yeah, apparently it's a sport and it's very cool.
I saw a video of Mike Tyson yeah. throwing a knife blindfolded at a darts board and he got it in
You're
the
kidding.
Bull's eye. 2 times in a row.
You're kidding.
No.
I need to go on YouTube that.
You
that
need
sounds
to YouTube
amazing.
That. You must. Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah, no, huge respect, huge amounts of respect for all of the athletes that competed, whether they were there to compete or whether they were there to have fun. You know, at all different walks of life. One of the days there was a 99-year-old woman that ran
99.
The 100-meter race. Yeah. And she ran it in honor of her daughter, who was about 63, I think, mm-hmm. And she was lesbian. So her mom, 99 years old, broke the world record for the oldest person or the oldest woman to run the 100-meter race. And it was just incredible. And, you know, that was the caliber of competitiveness that was there. And it was, she obviously won gold in her category. Mm-hmm. And it was just inspiring to see something like that.
That sounds really inspirational.
Yeah.
Now, how does the rest of the world think, do they know a lot about how South Africa works? especially when it comes to gay rights, LGBT rights?
You know what? I would say not the whole world is educated. I mean, obviously we're not all educated about everyone's
about everything,
rights,
yeah.
And it becomes quite difficult. But you know, it's just human nature when it comes to generalization. And when you say you're from South Africa, it's, oh, you're from Africa, and then, oh, shame, are you guys even allowed to be gay there? And we're blessed, as I said, in our country. And yeah. Some other countries in Africa, you know, I hope to start a wave of change where, you know, people can just be who they are and who they were born to be. So. Yeah.